Yeah, I hope you guys can share. I can see my screen. Okay naman. So, yun. Muli, maraming salamat sa mga organizers sa pag-organize ng Pista ng Mapa this year. Maraming salamat sa opportunity for giving me the time to talk about this. And maraming salamat sa lahat ng umattend. hindi lang ngayong araw, kundi for the past 3 days. It's been a wonderful 3 days being with you guys. So, yun. My talk for this afternoon is just about, you know, data presentation, right? So, something that I think a lot of us will find interesting, and at the same time, siguro a lot of us will find useful. So, sino ba ako? If you're here for the past 3 Pista ng Mapa days, or if you've heard me before, alam niyo na to. For the benefit of those whose first time it is to see me, or for the first time yung umattend ng Pista ng Mapa, hi, magandang hapon. My name is Ben. I'm currently doing a lot of things. I'm the proprietor and founder for BNHR, or Benhur, where I provide advocacy and consulting work services on openness, data, and geospatial. I'm also currently the data training lead for the Open Knowledge Foundation. We are an international not-for-profit organization whose goal and his vision is to create a fair, free, and open future. And of course, I'm the CTO and head of strategies for Smart City. We're a tech nonprofit here in the Philippines whose focus is to build citizen-centric and open by default solutions to smart community problems. So yun nga, tulad ng sabi ko for the past 3 days, I work around this openness, data, technology, and geospatial field a lot. If you want to learn more about what I do, you can find me, miniature.xyz, on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and my website. But today, or really for the next few minutes, pag-usapan natin yung isang bagay that I actually do a lot in all my 3 roles in the 3 organizations that I represent, right? And that's about helping people become more data literate. And when I talk about data literacy, it's not just about skills. No, it's not just about data skills. It's about, you know, giving people the opportunity, different kinds of people, the opportunity to learn how to read and how to use data. So hindi lang dapat data scientists yung gumagamit ng data, right? Ang lagi kong sinasabi, you know, the field of data is far too important to be left to data scientists. Specifically for the next few minutes, we'll talk about presenting and visualizing data, right? This won't be, again, a comprehensive list of kung ano yung mga kailangan natin, what we need to know about. But it should provide you with some basic rules, some things to be wary of when you're creating your data presentations, some things to consider. And at the end of it, I will show you 2 examples. Well, 2 examples of free and open tools that can help you create, you know, better maps and visualizations easily for your next projects, right? So let's start. Some basic rules first. The process of creating a data presentation or a data visualization is a process of compromise, right? The presenter before me, sabi niya, right? Some beginner map makers, yung isang fault nila is they try to put everything on a map. And the same with data vis people. Sometimes you try to put everything on the visualization kasi iniisip mo, kailangan lang malaman tong lahat. But in reality, right, we have to compromise to provide yung proper emphasis sa message lang na gusto nating ipakita, right? So whenever you present data, whether it be a map, a chart, there's always a compromise going on, and it's choosing, you know, what to emphasize with your graphic, with your map, etc. So ano yung mga bagay na to? What are these things that we can choose to emphasize? First is we can choose to emphasize our data. So this usually involves just creating very simple visualizations that people are familiar with so that they can quickly get a grasp of, you know, the key values, the key figures that you need. So a simple bar chart showing the number of cases of COVID, for example, at different ages. Sobrang simple lang na visualization yan. You're focusing on the data. You're focusing on telling people or showing people kung ano yung sinasabi ng data mo. So with web visualization, sometimes it allows for more interactivity, and in fact, mas may ability yung mga users mo mag-explore ng data mo. So you can emphasize the data, but you can also emphasize the design, right? In this case, probably people aren't as familiar with the data that you're trying to present. It might be a niche data set. People might not be familiar with the chart that you're creating. So kailangan mong gawa ng bagong, you know, bagong baga, kailangan mong galagyan ng spin para mas ma-retain ng mga tao yung bagay niyo. So that's when you try to emphasize the design, right? The goal here is to make your content memorable. It might not be simple, it might not be as easy to look at, but it's memorable, right? And then the last thing that you can choose to emphasize is your message, right? This generally means putting storytelling at the forefront. Kumbaga, inuuna mo yung kwento. Yun yung gusto mong i-focus sa visualization or sa presentation. The best things that I've seen of examples of these are scrollytelling maps. So if you've seen yung mga scrollytelling maps by Mapbox, for example, built with S3 story maps, or kahit yung mga ginagawa lang ng mga tao by themselves na storytelling map, sobrang gaganda nila. They put focus on the story and yung background mo, yung maps mo and your visualizations, right? So once you've decided what kind of emphasis you want to put or what kind of thing you want to emphasize, the next question is, how do I choose my visualizations, right? Ang hirap nito, and there's so many ways, and there's so many visualizations to choose from, right? First thing you have to ask yourself, what data do you have? Ano ba yung data na i-visualize mo? Is it categorical? Is it numeric? Right? Is it a time series data set? Is it geographic data? Is it a data showing, you know, networks between people, between objects? So you have to first understand, ano yung data na meron ka? And then you have to ask yourself, what relationship do you want to emphasize with your data, right? Kasi magbabago rin yung visualization or yung chart or yung presentation that you will choose depending on the relationship that you want to emphasize. So these are just example relationships. You might want to show correlation. You might want to show ranking. You might want to show comparison, distribution. You just want to create a map. So understanding those two things, what kind of data do you have and what kind of relationship you want to show, lamang ka na agad. Malalaman mo agad kung, magkaka-idea ka agad kung anong klaseng visualizations yung pwede mong gamitin. And that leads you to, back to the question. Okay, Ben, I know my data. I also know the relationship that I want, but come on, what visualization should I use, right? And this is one of the things that you can go to kung nalilito kayo. Use data visualization catalogs available online. Sobrang dami nila. Some even provide you steps on how to create, you know, the visualization in R, in Python, in Google Sheets, in Datawrapper, and all other visualization applications in Tableau, in Google Data Studio, right? Ang dami. So try to utilize these data visualization catalogs. Most of the time, papakita niya sa'yo, okay, so this is my data and this is the relationship I want to show. What kind of visualizations are apt for my use case? So just a list of data visualization catalogs. Andami pa. It's not an exhaustive list, but these are the ones that I use a lot when I am trying to decide what kind of visualization I will do based on the data that I have. So try to check them out. And yung biggest thing that I would like to tell you guys is, when in doubt, just always consider your audience. Sila pa rin yung importante. It's not about you show. It's not about you creating the visualization. It's about them understanding the visualization, right? So yun, let's go to our very first wag natin gagawin or beware of. So beware of data fallacies, right? Data can lie, and data lies a lot. So dapat aware tayo, both as a data practitioner and also as a data user, someone who sees visualizations, kung ano yung mga charts, graphs, and infographics na nagbibigay sa atin or gumagamit ng fallacies. So cherry picking, data dredging, survivorship bias, and things like that. Maging mapanuri kumbaga, maging mapanuri sa mga visualizations na ginagawa natin, pati na rin sa mga visualizations na nakikita natin. So for example, cherry picking, pinipili mo lang yung part ng data na ipapakita kasi yun yung, that's what meets your goals. Wag tayong ganun. Survivorship bias, you've seen this a lot on social media. It's also very common. It's a very common bias. You get a conclusion from an incomplete data set. So, wag ganun. And of course, gerrymandering and the modifiable area unit problem. The way that you divide the area will result in different conclusions depending on paano mo siya dinipide, right? So we try to make better data presentations all the time, right? So for example, this table, how can we improve that? This is vaccination rollout in the ASEAN. We're comparing countries based on the number of doses administered, right? It's better probably, and this is me, you know, normalize it per population. Not all countries have the same population, so of course you don't expect countries with, you know, like Brunei to have more doses than the Philippines, right? Kasi mababa yung population nila. So yun. Normalize, please. Ito pa, how can ito, sakto sa sinabing pie chart, how can this chart be improved? In sa lahat, too many slices. Have you looked at how many slices there are? And the slices are not really proportional. Tingnan niyo yung DOF tsaka DOH, tsaka yung DH tsaka DOH. They're not as proportional as you'd like, right? So, sabi nga, how to improve your pie charts, right? That's how we improve our pie charts. Well, don't get me wrong. I get na may times na pie charts are useful. It's not just all the time. Right? May times na hindi talaga pwede yung pie charts. Right? So yun, what we can do is probably just, you know, a bar or a column graph. Mas madaling tingnan, mas ordered, easier on the eyes, right? So let's not create mga ganitong charts, please. Let's try to improve on things like this. Yung average female height ng weird ng chart na yan. Sobrang weird. So yun, if you don't want to create things like that, I have a few things na for us to consider while creating our next data visualizations, right? So the first thing is try to start from nothing. You know, when you're creating bar charts, you know, try to start from zero. It's a more accurate and truthful representation of data, especially if you're comparing data sets. Kasi when we don't start from zero, it, relatively speaking, nagmumukhang mas malaki yung change between one category and another. But if we start from zero, then makikita natin yung actual relative change over time. So that's one. Second thing is size matters, right? Probably not in a lot of other areas in life, but in creating charts, it does. You know, it's easier to compare lengths and areas than volumes. This is one of the reasons why a bar chart will usually work better than a pie chart. Although, yun nga, there are studies that show na hindi naman ganun kalaki yung difference. And there are other charts that you can use aside from a pie that will show you parts of a whole. A waffle chart, for example, would probably work better kasi square siya, hindi pies na cuts ng pie. Or just a table. Then yeah, don't go over the rainbow. Use color for communication, not decoration. Unless your goal really is yun nga. Your goal is to be artistic about it. If your goal is siguro to communicate, sometimes too many colors can disorient, and be mindful of your choices of color, right? Hindi lahat, there are members of the community who are colorblind or who experience some sort of visual impairment. always make sure to try to create visualizations and presentations that are friendly, right? Inclusive. And in relation to that, save ink, or better known as avoid chart junk, you know, KISS. Keep it simple, suave. And don't put too many elements, and just focus on what the message, the data that you want to emphasize, right? You can do away with background shadings, check textures. Like for example, you see a chart, lalagyan mo siya ng yung parang lalagyan mo siya ng background yung bar na floor o kaya wood. We can do away with that, right? We can do away with that. And then keep right. This is something that I do a lot when I kahit tables lang. You know, align numbers flush right. Makes it that much easier to compare them. And if you can align them by the, you know, decimal point, much, much better. Falling in love with 3D, yun. Ang ganda ng 3D example kanina ni Sir Fabs. Because of course, the data, right? The data right there is already 3D. But for stuff that are not in three dimensions, medyo iwasan natin. 3D bar graphs. Ito yung pinakamalala, yung 3D pie chart. And unless you're plotting something that is actually 3D, it's sometimes better to stick to 2D charts, right? And yun, back to basics. Why use a chart if you can just use a number, right? Or a table, right? Why do all of that stuff when the most memorable thing that you can put is actually just write a number, you know? On the Apple approach, you don't see them comparing stuff, creating charts on our presentation. No, they just put 50% lighter, 1.2 inches thinner. Yun lang, right? And it works. So sometimes we don't need charts. Sometimes going back to basics is all right. But yeah, there are always exceptions. Everything that I've said, pwede niyong kalimutan yun. Because there are always exceptions. Right? From Wikipedia itself, adapted from Wikipedia, you know, if a rule prevents you from improving it, ignore it. If you think you can improve on something and a rule says wag mong gagawin yan, ignore that rule. Try to improve it, right? So adapted from Wikipedia's own rules. If a rule prevents you from improving Wikipedia, ignore it. Same thing with visualizations, right? By all means, break the rules and break them beautifully, deliberately, and well. Pero, right, yung concept ng rule breaking, it's only actually useful and helpful once alam mo na yung rules. Once may experience ka na creating maps, once you have experience creating your charts, once you already know what is good, what is bad, and what can be improved. So of course, at the very start, unlocking tulong ng mga rules na yon, just to see how things work, what kinds of visualizations you can do. And then later on, once you have more experience, pwede mo nang sabihin na sarili mo na, that rule doesn't make sense for this project. I can bend that, I can break that. Right? It only becomes helpful, that idea of breaking rules, when you already know what you're doing. Right? So kung medyo sanay ka na, nakapaka pa mo na, okay na, pwede na yun. Then just think about the goals of your visualization. Is it to innovate? Is it about serving a purpose for social good? Is it about evoking emotion? Is it about really just showing the complexity and truthfulness of data? Or is it on anything else? And of course, lastly, if you know your goals, how do you prioritize? You know, how do you prioritize actually and balance the goals of your visualization? Okay. So those are just some of the rules. We now jump yung sa next part, which is I'll show you two tools that I like to use. There are a lot of free and open tools online, free as in freedom and free as in food. Ito yung basic comparison nila. I'll show you yung dalawa na X dun sa tatlo or check dun sa tatlo na free as in freedom, free as in free food, and also cloud-based. And that is Datawrapper and RAWGraphs, right? So Datawrapper is an open source database platform, allows you to create awesome charts and maps in like 5 minutes. Sobrang ganda. And then RAWGraphs, RAWGraphs, also for database framework. Kaka version 2 lang nila, if I'm not mistaken. So let's go over this once. Bilisan lang natin. So let's start with Datawrapper. You can go to datawrapper.de, app.datawrapper.de, and then actually if you go to just datawrapper.de, it will ask you anong klaseng bagay yung gusto mong i-create. A map, a chart, or a table. Right? So for my case, gagawa ko ng bagong map. So when you start creating a map or a chart or whatever it is you want to create, see Datawrapper, it will ask you for the data, of course. So I'll create a chlorophyte map, a very simple chlorophyte map. And meron ng pre-built geospatial information dito. I can actually just search for the Philippines. But you can also upload the map. But take note, only GeoJSONs and TopoJSONs are accepted and file size should not exceed 2 MB. So mga shapefile lovers, I'm sorry. hindi kayo pwede dito. Export nyo muna sa GeoJSON. So let's go to Philippines 2018 provinces, right? So ito yung information. I've now selected my map. I will click proceed and I will now add information sa data ko. Now, adding information is as simple as copy pasting data, adding to remote data sets, Google Sheets or API endpoint or anything that has the raw data. And you can just think of this for those na nag-GIS, it's a join. It's basically a join. You're joining these names with your values, right? So in my case, meron akong data na kinopy-paste ko dito and yun. So ang titingnan nyo, may mga pula-pula na may mga pulang tawag dyan. Na rows dito. Ibig sabihin niyan may mali. So kailangan natin siyang linisan, right? So when you add your data, it's either you can clean it outside, but you can also clean it sa loob. So I know the value here is 51. I know that this is supposed to be just Cotabato, right? And I know that this is supposed to just be Samar, right? And next, nalinisan ko na siya inside, I can proceed to actually visualizing the data, right? And pwede ko nang actually gumawa ng a very simple map na pwede kong i-embed, pwede kong i-download, which shows yung number of participants, registrants ng pista ng mapa. Actually created another one kanina with more data sets, with more information. So saan galing ang mga nakipista? It shows you the distribution kung saan tayo nang galing. Plus yun, kung ano yung ating pronouns na preferred, right? So maganda yung geographic distribution natin sa pista this year, right? So that's how to create simple maps in Datawrapper. Of course, you can also create a chart, and I'll just use you can have different ways to add data. I will just paste mine. This is again Pista ng Mapa 2021 information. You can check if the data is correct. And then we can visualize this. I will select a split bar chart, right? And this shows you yung distribution naman ng participants natin in terms of age and also their preferred pronouns, right? So in less than 2 minutes. So last one before we finish off, RAWGraphs is also another database platform, free and open source. So ang gusto ko sa RAWGraphs siya sa Datawrappers, they're free and open source, meaning you can actually deploy your own. Gusto mong gumawa ng sarili mong version, deploy it on your own server, go lang, right? So RAWGraphs.io, ang gagawin ko dito, papakita ko dito is I can actually get data from a URL. This is the URL that I'm getting. This is data from my thesis. So I'm gonna make a very basic hex bin. I'm gonna drive, oh, so ito pala yung mga choices nyo. Sobrang dami, di ba? Choices nyo ng charts. You can even show based on the kind of chart that you want, the kind of relationship that you want. And then I'm just gonna go my X, my Y, and I now have my bin chart that I can actually modify, right? Automatically. And if you want to scale your hexagons based on the number, pwedeng ganyan. So remember yung last time ginawa natin to sa queue? Na ang dami-dami ko pang ginawa. Yeah. Ngayon lang siya dito. And you can even try if you want, just try their sample dataset. Sobrang dami. Kobe Bryant shots. Miss you, Kobe. Yun. Ang dami nila ditong datasets that you can play around with. Right? Yun. So, that was Datawrapper and RAWGraphs. So yes, maraming salamat sa pakikinig. I hope you got some things from my presentation. Again, you can find me online, bnchart.xyz, also on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube. Maraming salamat.